Hi, this is Matt with Custom Car Grills for our video on the 2010 through 12 Ford Taurus. The first thing I'll do is flip the grill over and locate the tabs that hold the grill together. I find that a Dremel with a number 543 cutoff wheel is the quickest and easiest way to cut these off. There's quite a few of these tabs around the grill, and with all of them properly cut, the black plastic mesh should easily come out. The center bar now needs to be removed, and I generally find it easy to manage with a handsaw, though the Dremel with the cutoff wheel could also be used. With the center bar removed, I've now got a frame to work with, but I need to get an even cutting depth. To get that consistent depth, I'm going to use some half-inch masking tape. Applying this tape is the most important part of the preparation, and it's best not to rush through it. There's a noticeable edge on the outer rim of the grill, which the tape should follow the contour of, and can be seen here. If the taped edge doesn't look smooth or consistent, then it may need to be repositioned or redone before moving on. When the tape is finally applied where it looks correct, I'm going to grab my Dremel and equip it again with the number 543 cutting and shaping wheel. From here, it's just a matter of cutting along the tape edge. I like to keep the cuts about 1/32 to 1/16 of an inch away from the tape, just in case I slip a little bit. I like doing the lower section first, before moving on to the top edge. A cut near the upper corners, like this, should be made to section off the top and bottom areas. Now I'm going to move to the upper edge that I've taped off just like the lower area was. This cut is much easier than the previous one, and the Dremel can make short work of it. The cut piece can be discarded, and it's time to start picking off some of the burnt plastic bits that may still be stuck to the grill. There's one tricky cut in the corners that needs to be made to complete the bulk of the cutting. Next, I need to shape the remaining plastic back a little bit closer to the tape. To do that, I'm going to use the top edge of the cutting wheel. The top of the wheel is very abrasive and works great for delicate work like this. Sometimes it's easy to shape the plastic with the grill standing up. And other times I find better results with the grill laying down. In either position, it's best to really pay attention and take my time to make sure that the cuts are smooth and even. The upper corners again may need a little touch-up to make a seamless transition all the way around. With all the cuts and shaping done, the tape guide can be removed and discarded. Now, I'll grab some sandpaper of varying grits to refine the cut edge more. I like starting with a 100 grit paper and then smoothing it out with something finer later. Once finished, the back of the edge should be nice and smooth. Most importantly though, there should be a very consistent half-inch depth remaining on the stock grill. If not enough was cut, then more work with the Dremel may be needed. And if too much was cut, then some body work may be needed to rebuild those portions back up. Next, I'll prep the grill for paint by sanding the inner and outer edges. It's usually best to strip the grill of the chrome if a color swap is desired. For this install, we ended up doing a blue paint job to color match it to the customer's car. Now, let's check out the mesh piece we have for sale on our website. This comes pre-cut and pre-bent to fit the grill after the grill has been gutted out, as shown in this video. To start the mesh installation, the first thing to do is flip the grill face down. With all the right cuts made, the mesh piece should fit on the back of the opening. To temporarily hold the mesh to the grill, I'm going to use some cable ties and some foam. The soft foam protects the painted surface from the tension of the cable ties. From here, it's just a matter of looping the tie around the grill and through the mesh, and then fastening the ties. It's best to have the ties snug, not too tight or too loose. With the ties tied, the tail ends can be trimmed off. To bond the mesh and grill together, I like using an adhesive called automotive goop. Applying the goop on this grill is a little tricky, and I like using a toothpick to get it in all the correct areas. I ended up using a lot of adhesive. I went through almost 2 bottles to ensure that the mesh was bonded strongly, and then let this cure for about a day. Once the goop is set up, the ties can be cut off and then the foam can be removed. Well, let's check out the finished product and see how this turned out. Wow, that's a huge transformation this has been. This looks like a completely different grill, and the new color matched and black theme is very sleek. Here's an example of what this grill looks like installed. It's a great look that works well with any Taurus from this year range. I hope you liked this video, and if you have any questions about this installation, feel free to contact me.